This video tutorial is intended for graduate students using Montezuma Publishing formatting templates. If you started writing your thesis or dissertation in a document and would now like to use one of our templates, you should perform a subdocument import. Following these steps will assist with safely copying your existing documents into the appropriate template for your program. The subdocument import procedure will ensure that the template styles are not corrupted by conflicting formatting that you could accidentally bring over with a simple copy-paste function. Before you begin, you will need all of your original files, and you will need to download the thesis template or dissertation template found on our website at montezumapublishing.com. The template and these instructions are designed for Microsoft Word. If you do not have Microsoft Word, you can get it through the link in the description of this video. This tutorial is conducted using Windows 10 and Microsoft Word for Microsoft 365 version 2301. Different versions of the operating system or MS Word may look different, but you should still be able to complete these steps. Let's get started. You'll need to open your original file and scroll to the first page of the body text of the document. Do not include preliminary pages. So this means you're going to skip to Chapter 1 or to your introduction. Select the whole body text, starting from the first chapter label or section title to the end of the document. This includes references and appendices if you have any. Then copy the selected text. Next, you will need to open up a new Word document. Paste the selected text from your original document into this new Word doc and save it as a new file. In our office, we name this file Thesis Body or Dissertation Body. It is very important that you close the new document before you begin the subdocument import. If you do not do this, the import will not work properly. Don't skip this step. Okay, so you separated out your body text into a new file, saved it on your computer, and closed it. Now you need to open the template that you downloaded from our website and save that as a new document. We usually name these files with the author name underscore ongoing. Check the option to maintain compatibility with previous versions of Word. If you don't, some of the template styles may not work properly. Saving a new version at the start ensures that you have an unaltered template on hand in case something doesn't work and you need to try again. In the saved template file, scroll down to Chapter 1. Select all text beginning at the first sentence that says, "If you haven't done so already," through the text on the last page. Then delete the selected text. You should make sure you read the text included in the template before you delete the contents. There are a lot of instructions and examples included in the sections you are deleting that are designed to help you with your formatting. If you need to refer to them in the future, you also have the unused version of the template that you downloaded from our website. After you have deleted the text, select the View tab from the menu bar at the top of your screen. Then select Outline and click Show Document from the ribbon. New options will appear after you click Show Document. That's when you want to click Insert. This will make a file selection window pop up. Select the document saved on your computer that you want to import. This should be the new body file you created at the beginning of this procedure. As you can see on our screen, a message box will appear. It says, "Subdocument Thesis Body has a different template than its master document. The master document template will be used." This is MS Word telling you that your original document, Thesis Body, is a different template than the formatting template or the master document. And that is true. There is only one option, so we always select OK. Another message box may appear if you have duplicate style names in your original doc and the template. In this instance, the message says style chapter label exists in both the subdocument you are adding, thesis body, and the master document. Would you like to rename the style in the subdocument? And then it gives you four options: yes, yes to all, no, or no to all. It is your choice if you want to rename your styles so they are unique or just use the styles in the template. The template already contains all of the styles that you will need to format your document, so it is our recommendation that you select no to all. Okay, Now that your original text is in the template, click on the body text. This will make the unlink option in the ribbon available. Click unlink. This step is very important. If you do not do this, the import will not work and you may need to start over. Your file will look normal on your computer, but when you send it to Montezuma Publishing, it will only show a path to where the thesis body file is saved on your computer. So do not skip this step. Performing a subdocument import will always add a section break before and after the text that was imported. These section breaks are superfluous and can cause errors in pagination and margins. Delete these section breaks after the subdocument import and before you begin formatting your document. There are multiple ways to view section breaks. You can see them when you're in outline view as a line that spans across the document screen, or you can close outline view and go to the Home tab and click on the paragraph symbol. For page breaks that are difficult to delete, we recommend using the View and Outline option. In either Outline view or Print Layout view, you can select the section break by moving the section break to its own line by hitting Enter, placing your cursor at the beginning of the break, and holding Shift Control, and then pressing the right arrow key. After the break is selected, hit the Delete key. Make sure you do not delete the section break after the last preliminary page and before Chapter 1 or your introduction. Removing that section break will introduce multiple formatting errors, so leave that break intact. Take a look at your unused template for the proper format if you need a visual reference. Be sure to close Outline view to begin formatting your document. The last step is to save your work. And you're done! Now you can continue working on your file in the template, which includes all of the styles needed to correctly format your document. You can verify the success of the import by checking the styles against the unaltered template. Make sure that any extraneous styles transferred over from your original are not being used. Don't forget to fill in the unformatted preliminary pages with your information, and you're good to go. For more information or a PDF copy of these instructions with screenshots, please visit our website at montezumapublishing.com or contact a graduate publishing associate by email at thesis@aztecmail.com. Happy formatting!